One of the most important things you can do when you read about an experiment is to think about whether the comparison that the researcher makes any sense. In the case of randomized controlled trials, you have an intervention condition and you have a control condition. The reason that we do that is that if the intervention group outperforms the control group, we want to be able to say that it was the intervention and nothing else that made the difference. But not all control groups are created equal. And if you're not careful, you can be tricked into thinking that an experiment showed something when it really didn't. A passive control group is one where people don't do anything special. Imagine that I have one group of people do a merry jig, and I have another group of people do absolutely nothing. And at the end, I give them both a test to see who feels happier afterwards. Now, if we're trying to figure out whether dancing a merry jig makes people happier, this is a really bad test. It's a bad test because the comparison is not specific enough. The people who danced a jig might be happier because they danced a merry jig, or they might be happier because they danced a jig, or they might be happier because they danced and the other group didn't, or they might be happier because they did something, anything, that was not nothing. The comparison is not specific enough to say anything about these competing explanations, which means that the evidence that you get out of an experiment like this isn't really all that helpful. So what would an active control be? An active control would be any comparison group where people actually did something. So maybe we have a control group that does some other physical activity instead of dancing a merry jig. Or maybe we have a control group that does a sad jig instead of a merry jig. Or maybe we have a control group that just imagines they do a merry jig. All of these would be active control groups, but they don't all answer the same kind of question. When we compare a non-dance physical activity to dancing a merry jig, we're exploring the difference between dancing and not dancing. When we compare a sad jig to a merry jig, we're exploring whether the emotion of the dance makes a difference. When we compare dancing a merry jig to imagining dancing a merry jig, we're comparing whether the physical activity, the physical action itself, makes a difference. The choice of a proper comparison group depends on the question you are asking, and one comparison alone is probably not going to be enough to answer the question of whether dancing a merry jig makes people happier. But if you do a bunch of experiments with meaningful control groups, then you start to have an answer to your original question. For more on how to read and understand social science research, you can check out some of my other videos. See you next time.